You have news? From Holland? The Earl of Leicester is safe.
Madam, we have intercepted a coded letter from the so-called Queen of Scots to Sir Anthony Babington. A copy of the original. And here, the transcript.
The affair being thus prepared and forces in readiness, both within and without the realm, then will it be time to set the six gentlemen to work on the Queen's murder. She gave me her word.
Proof positive she conspires against you, madam.
How came you by these letters? Do we have someone of ours in her confidence? And if so, is this his scheme or hers?
These gentlemen approached her, Your Majesty, and she has countenanced their scheme and given it her encouragement. This is plain evidence. She seeks your death.
As you do wish for hers, Sir Francis. You've already marked it with the gallows, or did Queen Mary make that mark herself?
There is no lie or counterfeit laid here before you, madam. And though it called down the wrath of Spain upon us, I say she should be dealt with.
I will not move precipitately, sir. Spanish built ships these last years, and we have none to put against them. I will not move too soon. I will write to the Earl of Leicester.
Whatever the Earl's view, madam, we must advise you that...
I'm the subject of plots and conspiracies, and all I have to defend me is you and sad old Lord Burley. I want Leicester, bring him home!
The army, madam, have need of their general.
So, your spy, our spy. Who is he, Walsingham?
The young man who once tried to kill you, madam. We turned him. I've done what I've done for your safety, madam. Mary of Scotland is a traitor.
So. Do you think because I'm slow to make war that I'm merciful? You think women are kinder than a man, are more gentle? I'll tell you, gentlemen, we women have forgotten more about cruelty than you could ever remember. What we do not like is lies. Why should I not hang you as well as the fellow Catholics you've duped? And I tell you, sir, we'll hang them not a whit before we cut them open for a traitor's death. Shadows. And shadows of shadows. Being alive is punishment enough for this creature. For the others, kill them as I have said. I want them alive when you cut out their heart, their bowels! I mourn more for the death of one good and faithful man than I do for 20 traitors! And now, with those I love across the seas, risking their lives for my life, I tell you I would hang those conspirators myself! Oh, I'm made of cruel passions, my lord. And when the time is right, we'll so act on them as to astonish the world. I have love and compassion, too. And as I can punish, so can I yearn. For those who are true and faithful and who love me according to my true deserts as their queen.